What's up, Samurai? We are back in some more Trove, and today is going to be a special video because today we're going to be talking about the new mounts that you can end up getting in Trove, and I am not in any way talking about the new event mounts. I'm talking about the new mounts that we can end up specifically getting from very specific areas that ended up coming up with the most recent Gunslinger patch. Now, as far as I know, you guys don't have these mounts on console yet, okay? So just keep that in mind that these are going to end up being special things that you'll eventually be able to get. There we go. Sorry, I'm looking for one of those little shop doohickeys right here because I wanted to start out by showing you the final mount, and then we'll kind of regressively go back and talk about all of the others, because in order to end up getting this mount in particular, you have to have unlocked all of the other mounts in the category. It's actually a very unique system that they've never done before in Trove, near as I can recall. And basically requires us to get all the error mounts, and then I guess this guy was just free because I didn't see any other cost ratio. So this guy is going to end up being kind of weird because not only does he look like a goofball, he's a weird little turkey goblin thing, but he also is going to end up putting down credits. And I don't know why he puts down credits. That implies to me he should be something out of the store. But the weird thing is that this guy will actually operate similarly to Gonda, kind of. So he doesn't create blocks in midair, but he'll create blocks from the ground. So like from where we're standing right here, we technically do have infinite jump, so long as we keep on jumping off of the blocks before they end up despawning, because if we end up letting them despawn, then we end up just falling and there's no way that we can end up resetting it. So you could kind of out jump the blocks as well if you end up going too far away from them. Not if we're going straight up vertical, but if we start moving forward, as soon as we do that, then we lose the trail behind us, right? So it's just kind of a cool gimmick. There's not really anything else to it other than the fact that it does this, right? So it's kind of neat. Anyways, let me get the patch notes for you guys so that we can end up talking about where you'll end up getting all of the other ones. Oh, that's weird. So the Trove website itself, for some weird reason, I guess like the link that I have in my patch notes video either just doesn't work because they deleted the post, or it's because the because it requires you to log into your Glyph account or something stupid. I really don't know. But anyways, let's go through them here. So there's gonna end up being a new category of mounts, which is the Bonewalker mounts. I don't know. Yeah, I don't think that they have their own specific category like in our inventory. I think they're just in the rare tab, and they're all going to end up being from different biomes. So they do end up seemingly, yeah, they do say where they drop from. So this is going to be a drop from T-Rexes found in the Jurassic jungle, which totally makes sense just because of how crazy beautiful he is. So that's just going to end up being in the Jurassic jungle biome. And you're just looking for these big boys right here. So they just can end up rarely dropping it. They actually end up dropping them a lot more common than you might think. I was able to actually get that mount, like just grinded myself, like for nothing. It was pretty easy to do, which was quite surprising because the other mounts are a little bit more unorthodox. So then there's going to end up being this one. So this says it's preferred mount of the Viking skeletons in Cursed Veil World. So this mount in particular will only drop from the specific enemies in Cursed Veil. So this is where I would give you guys kind of a quick tip for how Trove works. Even though this is all technically one connected large Cursed Veil biome, the way that enemies generate in this game is a chunk by chunk basis. And so you can kind of see like just on top of us like that, you know, see those other biomes to the north? That's a different chunk, right? So Trove kind of has chunks very similar to Minecraft, and certain chunks will end up generating normal skeletons, but then other chunks will end up generating these guys, which this is the Viking enemy. So what I'm saying is you could essentially end up finding like a whole bunch of chunks that just have tons of them, or you could just end up finding ones that just don't generate them. Those guys have a very rare chance of dropping one of these guys. I was farming them for quite a while and didn't end up getting any of this as a mount. or any drops, I should say. But either way, it gets worse, don't worry. So then there's this one. So this is rarely found from creatures in the primordial pit biome within the Delves.
So as far as I know, the Depth Stepper portal is only craftable. I don't think that you can buy it out of this merchant. I don't know why you would, because all this stuff is sold for credits anyways. But in the Delves workbench, in the Depth Stepper gateways, it's gonna be the first one right up here, the primordial pit. And unfortunately, you can see it's actually quite expensive. However, it is tradable, so you could farm the biome over and over again. The problem with a lot of the Delves is that, as you can see, it'll make the primordial pit biome spawn one or more times. So sometimes you could go in, have one biome generate, and then that's it. There's nothing else left. And that's kind of one of the worst issues with the Delves in general, though.
But anyways, that's where you'll end up being able to get this bad boy, which is a Triceratops with shields and axes and stuff. I don't know. He's very, very strange. But anyways, he's out of the Delves, which means that he's actually very, very expensive on the player market because all of these are, of course, tradable. And then there's this one. So this is rarely found within Primordial Pit within the Delves as well. So we've got two of them that are out of the Delves. This one's kind of, I think, is that a Stegosaurus or whatever? He's kind of stupid. He's an idiot. Kind of the exact same, the exact same biome. So, okay, cool, whatever, no harm, no foul. And then there's gonna be this guy. So this is found from Ashen Devourers within the Ashen Wastes of the Sundered Uplands, which is kind of weird that this goofy, dumb dinosaur that, like, I don't know, his tail's weird. It's weird that this guy is from the Ashen Wastes, but let me find one of these enemies for you guys. So the Ashen Wastes in the Sundered Uplands is going to end up being down here. This is the, the shadow side of the biome, right? Because of the uplands taking up all of the energy. I don't know if that's actually lore. I don't care. I'm just kind of speculating. But we're looking for, I don't think it's just these guys. It could be. Maybe those guys count as Ashen Devourers. If I'm not mistaken, it has to be the elites though, right? I could be wrong about that. If somebody's actually gotten this as a drop, you can let me know. I'm assuming it might actually just be off of the normal enemies, come to think of it, because of the fact that this mount in particular is actually one of the cheapest, which is kind of odd considering that, you know, the Ashen biome is like such a specific area. But I think these are the Ashen Devourers. I guess it doesn't matter whether it's an elite or not. It would just end up dropping off of just any old enemy. I don't have my torches equipped or anything. That's why it's taking so long. And then, of course, last but not least, is going to end up being the super poggy rare one that we ended up showing you, where he leaves the trail behind him for whatever reason. And all you're trying to look for is, you see this little outpost right here on the map, and it actually has a little up arrow, meaning that that's an outpost up top. So we're specifically looking for the outpost that's down here at the bottom, which means that it's going to end up having a red arrow on it. Let me get off of my mountain. Oh, there's one right there, conveniently. I can see it before the map even shows it up. And then we just can end up getting the mount from this NPC only once we already have all of the others. Now, I'll admit that for most of them, I just bought them off of the player market, and they were quite expensive, more particularly the Delve ones. But at the very least, it does mean that you as a player can grind all of these free to play, except for this one. I mean, you can grind it free to play, but you can't trade it. All of the other ones you can end up making quite a bit of a profit off of, more specifically the Delves, just because nobody wants to go in there. Anyways, thanks for watching. Smash like, sub for more, buy the merch you want to support the channel, and have a wonderful day, everybody.